Welcome to this edition of Reflective View. I'm your host, Bonnie Gilgallon. I'm here with the fabulous psychic and life coach, Patricia DeJoseph. And our guest today is Gina Walker. We're so excited to have her here. And we'd like Patricia to tell you a little bit about maybe how she got to know Gina.
Oh, that's an interesting start, definitely. Well, the first time that I actually connected with Gina, I saw this dynamo of energy on the altar at our church. And she so rocked the church that I don't think a single person could have left there not being fully charged with positive energy. Absolutely. And she has been that guiding force. I call her my angel, my dynamo angel, actually, because I don't think I ever, in any of the times I've ever connected with you, whether it's by text, in person, whatever, that even when you're going through challenges, you have not been so up and positive and so supercharged that no one can really be down around you. So I figured you're perfect person to be a featured guest on our show, because I'm sure everyone in our audience, everyone that watches this video, will feel that energy.
Well, I want to thank you both for having me on, and it is truly a joy to be here. Energy is very important because it is the presence that we live in. Mm-hmm. And our energy is what goes before us, is what we carry with us each and every day. So thank you for recognizing, Patricia.
You are so welcome, and I totally validate that, because everything in the universe is made up of energy, and most of us don't recognize that when we see things as solid. But everything is moving and vibrating at a certain energy. And what we as people do with our energy affects all those around us, including things, even though we don't recognize that. So when you put out that dynamic energy, which as I say, you always do, it just has such a positive effect on going outward and affecting those around you in a big way. I think sometimes even further beyond, or farther beyond, I should say more correctly, people that you touch lives. And I think you're such a beautiful, beautiful energy that glows like a light in a dark room.
Oh, how beautiful is that?
I wanted to ask you a couple things. Did you have this sort of energetic glow thing when you were little? And also, how did she's a wonderful singer, wonderful spiritual, gospel, pop, jazz, whatever, singer and public speaker. When did that start? How did you get into the musical world? And have you always had this spark?
Yes, and yes, okay. And yes.
Three yeses.
Yes, yes, yes. Energy, music, speaking. For me, there is no difference. It's all the one. And whether it is a rhythm, or it is a speaking, or if it's coming together, just sitting as we are, there's energy that's happening right here,
sure,
right now.
Right. Yes.
And so as a kid, I put on productions in my neighborhood. And if somebody couldn't do their part, I did their part too.
Hog it
I
off.
Didn't care, that's right.
And you were also director, producer.
I did whatever needed to be done mm-hmm. to get that doggone thing happening. Yeah. So for me, I've always known what my joy, what my
calling.
Was. Thank you. Is, has been, and how it has expanded. Mm-hmm. It was getting to a place of trusting that joy was enough. And that's mm-hmm. been a big thing for me, mm-hmm. to really get to a place of understanding that joy is enough. That, you know, it doesn't have to be, it's not about a job, about a gig, about a career. Mm-hmm. I'm really starting to immerse in the truth that being in joy is enough.
And you knew that as a kid?
No. As a kid, I just laughed.
God bless you.
As a kid, I just laughed.
Laughed
a lot.
Okay.
I did. Most kids, when they would get sleepy, would get irritable and cry. I would laugh. Mm-hmm. My mother would know that I was sleepy then. And she'd go, Gino, time to go to bed. Yeah. I'd lay in the middle of the floor being like, I would crack myself up over whatever.
Yeah.
And I still do that. Laughter helped me, as Patricia so beautifully said, that definitely, you know, there are times when I'm on the mountaintop and there are times when I'm in the valley. And laughter has been one of those beautiful gifts for me that has allowed me to shift.
Mm-hmm. Can I just interject one thing here?
Sure.
I just wanted to mention that there's actually a group here that meets for an hourly session once a month on laughter therapy.
Love
because
it.
They have found that
is that the
laughter,
laughing yogi? Or is that a different
yes,
thing?
Yes. Yes.
Okay.
And so, I mean, laughter is so healing and powerful. And they say just to laugh, it doesn't necessarily mean that there's something you've heard
absolutely.
That's funny, but that actual energy of laughing really has a magical effect on us.
It releases endorphins. I mean, your whole body
exactly.
yeah, changes.
It releases the serotonin mm-hmm. and you know, beyond that. And so therapeutic.
I agree 100%.
Was your whole family like that, or were you sort of unique in this?
Well,
embracing the joy.
Each person is unique.
Right.
And so, you know, when I look at my family dynamic, we all brought a different and special tweak
right.
to us being together as a family mm-hmm. and what that's all about. So there's creativity. We are a laughing family. When we get together, it's crazy
yeah.
because we will make fun of one another, mm-hmm. but not fun.
Not in a malicious way.
Yeah, just
loving way.
Loving way, and just really having a great time mm-hmm. with one another. So it's a beautiful thing.
So when did you your singing, speaking move into as an adult into the career arena?
Well, that's been interesting because as an artist. I've always been an entertainer, mm-hmm. and so that was very normal for me.
It seemed like the next step.
That
right.
was, you know, once I made the commitment to myself that I didn't have to do something and
right.
that I could do, you know, the universe started opening up and unfolding. And so it's the same thing that the very first time that I spoke was at a Unity Church, and the minister there had asked me a couple of months before if I wanted to speak, and I was like, what? You know, I'm not a licensed practitioner, mm-hmm. I'm not this. She said, you know, you speak to me all the time.
Right.
She said, you're anchored in consciousness.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, yeah, I know, I do the work. She
yeah.
said, when you get ready, just let me know. Well, mm-hmm. something happened, and she needed to find someone to replace. So she called me and said, it's
are
time.
Are you ready?
No, it was no, are you ready?
She just said, it's time.
It's time.
Yeah.
I was like, what? It's time. She
yeah.
said, I need you this Sunday. It's time. And as it would have it, I wasn't booked that Sunday to sing somewhere, mm-hmm. which is normally not the case.
Right.
My calendar is usually booked 6 to 8 months in advance. But I was available.
That was the universe saying, here you go. Yeah.
And it was the most amazing thing. The church was a small church, probably only holds about 100 people.
Mm-hmm.
That Sunday, all the power went out. I was singing and speaking, so there was no power. And the piano player said, well, it's a good thing you're here, Gino, because everyone will still hear you.
Mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
And I did the service, and for me, what was so amazing is that speaking was so natural. It was even more, I don't want to say a more or less, but there was a connection that I felt speaking that I had not felt singing.
Really? That's
yeah.
interesting.
It is.
Mm-hmm.
It was for me. Mind-blowing. And it still blows my mind.
Mm-hmm.
Because there is such a trust and... I think I just answered my own question. There's such a trust that unfolds when I'm speaking. There is no part of me that doesn't know that I can't do it. Singing, there were experiences that I had that, you know, sometimes you have experiences that,
woo, didn't work quite the way you wanted it to. Yeah.
That was not what I had in mind.
Yeah.
So I had taught myself, as we all do, I taught myself that I had to really be on top of it, blah, 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 boom, all
right.
the energy of that was unfolding from that. So, you know, you get the butterflies and,
right.
and all that
right.
good stuff, and that's all well and done. But with speaking, I had nothing
mm-hmm.
to go against it. So there was this natural trust that I just step into.
Right.
And I do that when I speak.
And so from that day on, then
yes.
you just started speaking everywhere in addition to singing?
Yes. That, it was like a little, they say the best advertisement is word of mouth.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
so it was word of mouth. It was yeah. the next place I went to said, I hear you speak too. I said, I do talk. Yeah. Hello. And I've had some wonderful ministers that have lovingly supported me as I've taken this journey. And so it has expanded me. And
now, where's home base for you?
That's a good question. Home base is the universe.
Okay.
I'm a universal artist. I travel all the time. I've been on tour since June.
And you've been all over the world. I mean, internationally talking travel, right?
Yes.
Didn't
I've
you go to Japan something not too
Australia,
long ago?
Germany, London, Sarajevo, Hungary. I've been blessed. I've traveled a lot. Mm-hmm. And continuing to travel.
And you had been a guest on my radio show back a few years ago.
Yes.
But I've been going to the Center for Spiritual Living, which is wonderful, and the music. And you, of course, were their featured guest a couple weeks ago and blew the roof off the place,
woo-hoo.
Which didn't surprise me at all. So you're going to be back there from time to time, I hope. Whenever
probably
you're
sometime,
available.
Yeah. Probably sometime next year.
Yeah.
We'll work out something and. I'll present my workshop again when I'm there.
Now tell me about your workshop. I don't
also,
know.
About your CD.
Yes.
Coming out.
Well, the new CD, I think it's going to be called Into the Deep, and we're working on that right now.
Mm-hmm.
So I expect it sometime next year, middle part of next year. Currently, I'm working on a campaign of inspiration.
Okay.
2 million downloads of inspiration, which you'll be able to go to my webpage and my YouTube page. And the idea is between Thanksgiving and Christmas to reach out to 2 million people.
Wow.
They'll
That's
have a video
fantastic.
That they will, a video of moi, called Everything is Possible. From that video, there'll be a link to download the song.
Mm-hmm.
So the idea is really to inspire people, to remind them that the importance of inspiration is the same as joy. That to be inspired by an idea, to immerse yourself into your dream, is what expands the consciousness of this universe. That's where I live from. That's what I believe.
And I want to tell you, we've been blessed today because I always look at different symbols as signs of good fortune.
Yeah.
And two of my favorites are a hummingbird and a butterfly.
Ah.
And while you were talking, both of them were overhead.
That's
an added note to put into
I
that.
I love it. I love it.
It blessed you.
Did you, and if you don't want to just, can you just give us a line? Just a couple words, just so they can hear you.
Everything is possible. Every dream is possible. Everything is possible.
Yay.
Because
I know some of us, myself, I know a lot of people, aren't where you are, and I think a lot of the reason is fear.
Ugh.
How do you get to your, if someone's watching this and they think, boy, I would love to be as joyful and full of peace and comfort, how do you get past that fear? Do you have a...
Well, I'm the kind of person, there's no easy way. And then I think the wonderful thing is that everybody has to find a way. The first step must be to make the choice.
Okay.
I'm just not going to allow this fear to control my life.
Okay.
Secondly, for me, is I'm the person that leaps off the mountain.
Just go.
Yeah.
Just,
that's how I do it. It doesn't work for everyone that way.
Right.
But I just run and leap.
Okay.
But if that doesn't work, really, the first thing is really making the decision that this thing, this conversation, this feeling, because fear has a feeling attached to it.
Right.
So when that feeling comes up, and my workshop is about that, releasing old thought patterns, is recognizing the feeling tone that you're getting with that. You know, the fear comes up, you wake up in the morning and you're happy and it's like life is so good, and then you go to the store, something hits you.
Right. Right.
It's in that moment that you want to recognize that I've got something going on.
Okay.
I got some fear running.
Okay.
And I'm just not going to allow it anymore. So what can I do? For me, nature changes. It shifts me. Mm-hmm. Can I just stop what I'm doing and look at nature?
Mm-hmm.
Can I watch the birds? They fly all over. Having a great time.
Yeah.
They have fun.
I love that you work. Is this workshop coming up soon? Is it something we can tell people about? Or can they check your website?
They can check my website.
Which is?
My website, GinoSings.com. That's GinoSings.com. That's also where you can go on and participate in the 2 million downloads of inspiration. You'll find out about my workshop. You can find out about
CD.
Where I am, my CDs.
Okay.
There's a lot of good stuff going on over there, so yes.
Patricia, if someone wanted to get a hold of you, what would they do?
Yes. Give me a call on my personal cell, which is always like an extension of my hand, so you can always reach me. And it's 760-578-6929. And you can also find me on Facebook, which our wonderful photographer, Renee, is going to post for you. So. Thank you so much, Gino. I totally love you. I am so grateful that you have come on today. And of course,
absolutely.
I love Bonnie. She is always tremendous to work with. And I think the most wonderful asset, we make a great team.
Yeah, you guys are fabulous.
Do you have some affirmation thought for the day to leave us with?
Yes. Our daily bread is the breath that we take. So if you can really hear that, that means with each breath that you take, all is well and all is provided, no matter what.
Fabulous. Jenny Walker, Patricia DeJoseph, I'm Bonnie Gilgallon. We'll see you next time on The Reflective View.
I love you guys. Thank you.
I love you.